Press the bell icon on the YouTube app to never miss a video from SNG Comedy.
Good evening, Bangalore. How are you guys doing? Make some more noise! All right, so this is the first ever time we're going to do the Big Question live. Fans of Big Question, make some noise!
Yeah!
Nice!
All right. So I'm just going to tell you guys.
It's also one of the very few times all five of us are there.
Yeah. Talia.
Well, someone's already making their own cut. That's amazing.
Okay, right. So I'm just going to quickly tell you how this is going to work. We've taken one topic that we've consistently got across our YouTube comments. So we're going to start off with that topic. We'll talk about it for about 20 odd minutes. And then we'll switch over to get topics from you guys. Select one live and then do that topic live here.
How's that sound?
Excitement?
That's not how you want it, okay.
So basically, we'll do the talking. It'll be like the Jaipur Lit Fest, only funnier.
Yeah.
Don't overcommit.
That's why I said funnier, not intellectual.
Okay. Wasn't Chetan Bhagat
vocabulary.
Chetan Bhagat at the Lit Fest?
Yeah.
That was pretty funny, though.
Yeah.
can't compete with that shit.
Can't compete with Chetan Bhagat. Okay, anyway. Shit. So we've been going across all the comments that we've got on YouTube, and every video has at least 2 to 3 people asking us to do this question live. And that question is, what are your drunk stories? Are you guys okay with that question? Do we talk about our drunk stories?
Is there anybody here who's never been drunk? Please yell.
The front row.
What? The front row. No one's ever been drunk.
In your life?
And him.
Out
and
of me. Choice. Out of choice.
Out of choice.
Out of choice.
Wow. Out of choice.
Obvious. There's nothing obvious about it.
Because I have something called Wilpa.
Well,
and no friends.
Okay, anyway, so we are going to start talking about our drunk stories. This video is being recorded to be put up on YouTube, so make sure you laugh louder. For anything, just laugh. Huh? Nice
just,
one. Well
just
done.
Do that.
Exactly.
You know that canned laughter, you get one person going,
and then on the comments, we're like, that was me laughing like a hyena. Do that.
Right after first comment.
Exactly.
Okay, so we're going to start today. Let's start with, okay, Adar.
Yes.
When was the first time you had a sip of alcohol?
Like
Varun forced you to take
yes.
Yeah.
True story.
I had a sip of alcohol. So it was at Karan's wedding. So this is like very recently. And these guys made me like do like 5.
So for all
shots.
Of you who don't know, Adar does not drink at
yes.
all.
He's like you guys. He's yeah. like you guys.
You know, you have the only thing he drinks is protein shakes. Apart yeah. from that, he doesn't drink anything. And so we always try to sort of pressurize Adar to drink. And it was Katie's engagement, I remember. And Adar was just sort of sitting in the side. And we were all like getting hammered. We're like, Adar, daru pina, nahi, nahi, nahi. Then eventually, I don't know how he mustered up the courage.
Yeah.
And he's gone straight for a whiskey shot.
I think we frustrated him into it. That
yeah.
was it.
Yeah.
Like, fuck it, Gandu. They were
just. Nahi, there were 5 lying there on that thing and nobody wanted to drink anymore. Like his wife, she was throwing up in the outside. And this guy is paying the bill and he doesn't know how much he's paid because the next morning is like 55,000. We didn't.
No. It was much more.
Yeah.
much more.
That's a conservative sum.
Yeah.
And it was getting wasted. And Bridge was the one who was like, pile, pile, pile. And then I got angry and had one.
That's what I'm saying. I think.
Yeah, and then off. Like, then it just started. Then I had like back
that's
to back.
Every alcohol incident
I
ever.
Remember one story.
One.
I remember one story of Adar. Okay, my cousin's wedding. Adar, again, weddings. Why does
oh, that's the one I remember.
Adar
yeah.
Adar
yeah.
had a couple shots. And he's at a table like this.
No, not
so Adar drunk is Adar stoned. That's
uncle,
what Adar is.
Karan's uncle was roaming around with a bottle of like this.
Okay,
this
we are Punjabis.
Cocktail.
This is what
yeah.
we do. This is what we do.
And he's just like shoving it in people's mouth. Like, I don't know. I was scared I'm going to contract something at that wedding.
But by the way, you probably did.
You yeah. did.
No, so I saw Adar outside. I went out for a smoke. I come back in, and suddenly my friend's like, isn't that your friend? And I see Adar at the reception in the hotel lobby sitting like this.
Yeah.
He's hungover even before.
Yeah, he's hungover before
alcoholism.
In my head at that point, I was contemplating life. Like, what is going to happen tomorrow? How am I going to live my life? What am I doing with everything?
Your dad be shocked.
Kautuk, when was the first time you had alcohol?
You have fans, Kautuk.
Massive fan base in Bangalore.
Fans.
How do I not see you on YouTube comments? What the fuck? Anyway, so the first time I drank was age 16. Okay, first time ever straight out of
8,
college.
16, you know, why do you remember the time?
Not
8:16.
Jesus,
oh, okay,
Varun.
Sorry. What sort of
8:16? Oh, no way, dude.
I heard 8:16. I'm like, that's very precise.
John, 3:16.
It would have been
8:16.
I don't know what was going on in Thakur's head at that point of time. Case the date ni mention kya kuch nahi. Just 8:16.
Okay, age 16. Okay.
Umar 16 saal.
Haan, Umar 16 saal.
देखिए इस वैश्य दरिंदे को
वैश्य दरिंदा मैं बन गया okay?
बन गया ऑफ कोर्स
फर्स्ट टाइम आई लाइक इट वाज कॉलेज ओके वी डिसाइडेड कि चल वी हैव टू डू दिस सो मी एंड टू अदर फ्रेंड्स ओके वी वेंट नाउ वी हैव अ प्लेस इन लाइक वी हैव अ हाउस इन बेलापुर ओके सो वी वेंट देयर द
बेलापुर
बेलापुर फ्रेंड्स
You know,
Belapur
yeah,
is
yeah,
yeah, yeah, I believe this.
Okay, in relation to Bombay, Belapur is really far off.
In okay, relation to Bombay, Belapur is the airport. Yeah. Just so you know, yeah. Belapur is where the airport is. That's
you, you
how
need
far
a, you need and a tourist visa to go there.
Also, the last place I thought Belapur would get a cheer is Bangalore. Fuck.
I think anyway, they heard you say Bangalore.
Bengaluru. So anyway, the like two of my friends and I, we went there. Okay. Now the thing is that we didn't know what alcohol was. Okay. So
what?
Yeah.
At 16.
So you went there means where?
So we went to Belapur, okay? And we're like, chal, let's get drunk.
let's get drunk, but you didn't know what alcohol was.
So we went to a shop, okay?
Of course. Like,
whiskey do, rum do, vodka do.
Oh.
Okay? And my idea of drinking was, I'm going to mix
all of
this.
Long Island iced tea.
Yeah, it was a Long Island iced tea. Now the thing is, we come back to our place, okay? Now, but two friends, okay? They're drinking responsibly. They've got mixers, okay? And they're using them. I, on the other hand, okay? I said, rum, whiskey, vodka, together. Let's do it. And I have everything, okay? The next thing I remember, okay, is waking up in my own puke, okay, with a sleeping bag over me. And no clothes.
None.
Zero. Zilch.
Zero clothes.
Okay, now I wake up, I'm hungover, but my friends are looking worse. Okay, I'm like, what happened? We saw you naked.
You always
drink
had this
responsibly
one guy,
by
right?
Kautuk
Shiva. No, you always had this one guy, especially your friends, that who will give you advice on what to do when you when you drink. Yes. Hey bro, daru piya na ghar ja, ek glass dudh pila, sab theek ho jayega. Do it.
Take Alka-Seltzer, put it in water, drink.
Har drink ke beech mein do glass pani pi.
Next morning ka advice hoga.
Yeah, when was the first time you drank?
First time.
In 1985.
Yes. In 1985, in my cousin's third wedding. No, so I'm not a drinker. Like, I'm not a proper drinker. The first time I tasted alcohol was peer pressure. I want to say Jai Hind College.
What brand is that?
Jai Hind College. everyone's like at this like freshers party.
Yeah.
And we have this like thing. Everyone's like, chik-chik-chik-chik-chik-chik. And I'm like, what the fuck
you're
am I doing
You're drinking wrong, clearly. Like, that's not how you're supposed
I'm
to be.
I'm still not. In this panel, I am the least drunk person. That's the problem. Okay. So, when I tasted it, the thing is, I don't like the taste of alcohol. That's my problem. Like, it's not like I'm averse to the idea of it. I just don't like the taste.
You don't have desi daru then. Why are you having desi?
No, anything. No, but I remember the only drunk story that I remember that was the worst story is when we were in London, there were three of us. We took a train really late in the night towards Wimbledon. And these two Indian guys with me are smashed. Okay, like smashed to the point
Wimbledon
where
and smashed, that's the
flash,
best.
Who has a flag hold rahe, hey, Great Britain, gaand mara, whatever, like just random. Kuch bhi bol rahe ho log, theek hai? So we are in the train. Abhi wo last station ke pehle na train ruk gaya re, 5-10 minute. So un logo ko solid mutne ka tha. Now they wanted to pee and they have no idea what to do. So they are like fully drunk. Aisa khola, jaake kopche. In the train, okay? They get caught next station, they're taken to the police station. Mere ko bhi leke gaya saath mein. Main bola, maine kya kiya? Maine thodi muta bro. Haan, witness. They were banned, dude, from London. 10 years. They block.
What? Banned from London?
10 years. No, from the United Kingdom.
If they did that in India, there would be nobody left here. Sab nikal jao bahar. Sir, India is a completely empty
country. Destruction of public property. Or sab kuch hai. They've had a brawl fight somewhere. They've gone and peed. They've been yelling at the flag. Aisa sab kuch kar rahe ho log.
I mean, why do they ban them? They should just put them into a soccer, like hooligan team, right? That's what they do.
Maro.
Thakur, tu bol.
First time I drank alcohol, this is a story that my parents told me. I was really...
You know you started too early when your parents are telling you.
I apparently used to love alcohol. when I was 4 years old.
Nice. Nothing's changed.
Yeah. No, I hate it now. So it started off as I was a really cranky baby. I would keep crying all the time.
Things changed.
Alcohol doesn't help.
Every time my parents sort of took me out with their friends, and if you're going anywhere, I would start crying.
Nothing's changed.
After a point, my parents like, fuck this guy. And they just started taking brandy and just had to pee.
Best solution ever.
Yeah, like they just started giving me brandy. Very irresponsible parents. I think.
Out, you're passing out.
We left, we want to dance. So my parents and their friends keep telling me that, where after a point, I think I started liking it, where I would just cry, not because I'm cranky, but because chie da.
Oh my God, you're like that baby in Indonesia that smokes cigarettes. You're like baby, but with daru.
He's that ulta of Jennifer Connelly in that movie, in Requiem for a Dream, where he will do anything to get his daru. So
no, I'm not going to get a two-sided dildo to get daru.
One person who's seen Requiem for a Dream.
So I was actually a very responsible drinker when I started. But on my 18th...
But when you went to America.
No. On my 18th birthday. on my 18th birthday, I decided I'm going to do 18 shots. And I didn't... I think I made it to like 11, and then I got thrown out of the bar. In fact, I got lifted. Somebody picked me up. I was out, and then literally, it's happened.
They tossed you out.
They tossed me out.
Which was a big thing, because Karan used to be fat. Like, just lifting him is a big deal.
Yes.
There was a huge guy, man. A huge guy picked
me
up.
Did you fall on your head?
No. They were pretty gentle, but I got thrown out. That was the nutshell of it.
Okay, so what's any crazy drunk story that you've been involved, apart from this?
So, I remember one time, I was just drinking with a friend. His name, first of all, his name was Annie. Nickname was Annie. And that's not because he was gentle. It's short for animal. Okay?
Wow.
So,
it's so misleading, Karan.
It's a big guy. And this guy, we were drinking at a bar, and he's like, I could see that it's coming up. Like, we were just shots, and it was coming up. He's like, bro, I gotta go. And he runs into the bathroom, and he tells me all this after what happened later. He goes in the bathroom, he kicks open one of those toilets, okay? And he pukes all over the toilet. Just blah, comes out. And he looks down, and there's a skinny white, a skinny guy with glasses sitting there on the toilet.
Ouch.
Wait, it gets better. So now my friend Annie has a decision to make. He's like, this guy is going to start fighting with me. Okay, I need to nip this in the bud. So he takes his hand and punches this guy across his face. Okay, he punches him. He comes back to me, he goes, we gotta go.
I feel really bad for the guy in the loo, dude. He's just like, sitting there.
He's like enjoying a shit. Suddenly, he gets puked on and punched in his face. What did I do?
Next morning, he's gone to his astrologer. Sir, I think my shani is bhari.
Or he's sending a message to his ex-girlfriend that he broke up. You bitch, how could you? And she's like, what the fuck?
No, so you know, like New Year's nights especially, right? Everyone gets like super tanked.
Yes.
This was about 4 years ago. We're all at a New Year's party and everyone's gotten drunk. And four guys and a girl. So my friend and his girlfriend, we've gone to drop them home. He's gone in to drop her. So obviously he's going to go make out and come out 20 minutes later. So we decide to just sort of chill. And this is 5:30 a.m. We're all drunk. I see an empty rickshaw. So I'm like, I'll just sleep. Lie down till he comes out. And then we'll go.
Such a Maharashtra.
This is what I told my friends. So,
and this coming from a bhaiya.
Yeah, this was probably a mama's rickshaw to begin with.
Mera rickshaw tha wo, okay.
So I told my friends, I said, I'm just going to lie down and we'll leave in wherever Mihir comes. They're like, yeah, okay, cool. Next thing I remember, it's 9:30 a.m. I've woken up. I'm seeing the time I look out and you see, you know those aunties who wear salwar kameez and sneakers? Those extremely aajkal ke naujawan dekho kya kar rahe hain aunties. Like that's the thing. Like I'm going to walk in the morning and just judge people. But I don't blame them because here's a guy who's just woken out of a rickshaw. Okay. I've woken up, I'm looking around. I'm like, where the fuck am I? Like, why am I in a rickshaw?
Aur bhada kitna hua hai? Okay.
But this is not a drunk Varun story. Okay. This has happened in Sri Lanka. These guys had gone for a show. And they've left Varun. Varun's gone to sleep at the airport.
Oh, yeah.
They've crossed customs and fucked off.
They took his passport too.
Varun's just sleeping. When he woke up, he's just making faces.
No, not this. Like, so when I wake up, I'm looking out for my friends. I'm calling out to all of them. I can't see anybody. I'm like, you know what? Fuck, what happened? I'm checking wallet. Everything's fine. I go home. I pass out, woke up the next day, and I'm on Facebook. And there's 180 likes. I was just like, what the fuck? I click on it and there's a picture of me that these fuckers have taken. And I'm 6 feet tall. Rickshaw is like, what, 2 feet?
So my feet are out like that. I've slept, and they've taken 4 different pictures of this and fucking put it up on Facebook. So that was, I think, the last time I drank irresponsibly on New Year's around those fucking friends of mine.
Yeah.
The worst story, like, this is the part, like, college, the first party I went to at 18, 19. And a friend of mine.
You went
was
to your first party at 18.
Like, proper drinking party, oh, okay. Not like like haath mein cake or chips wala party.
Samosa side mein.
So this is at some bungalow in like Mud Island, and these guys have gone there, and we've like a bunch of guys have they parked their cars, and everybody's partying inside the house. And this one friend of ours, he got this girl, and she was like a couple of years older. And he was like, oh, dude, I'm gonna do it tonight. Like, I'm gonna lose my virginity. So and the girl takes him like, oh, like there's trees and the cars are parked. So she takes them back because the bungalow mein kuch nahi ho sakta. It's just one area. So she takes him back there behind the cars and stuff. 20 minutes later, we hear the girl running, like her clothes are half off. She's running. She's screaming and running across. One of the guys who got really drunk, first time drinking, went there and pissed behind the car on them while they were having sex.
Wow.
It's just wow. This girl running.
Imagine the guy who's losing his virginity. How traumatized he is. How? He's never, like, every time he's having sex, he's like, oh, fuck, mutta mat.
He's just hoping nobody pisses off.
If the girl was on top, he's like, arey, wow, barish bhi ho rahi hai na, it's romantic.
Amazing.
I used to notice the kind of dancing that people used to start doing, because I know people who were normal, like, oh, nice dancers, like, just before they drink alcohol. And the moment they started drinking alcohol, they would start doing the cockroach dance. Now, the cockroach dance is when you flip a cockroach over and the legs are just moving around. The cockroach dance.
That looks really odd.
It's like Donald Trump's entire political campaign.
Okay, guys, do you have a drunk playlist? You know the playlist that you put on?
It's called Bollywood.
Yeah. Sure it is.
It's Jagjit Singh.
That is true.
I think Bollywood was made so you can enjoy alcohol.
No, but ghaati party music, dude. Like the
or Jagjit Singh, depending on what you're drinking.
Yeah, depending on what you're doing. You know what? This is what happens when all the girls leave at a party and it's just the drunk guys. Yeah. That's what happens. Yeah. Bollywood starts.
Tu mera yaar hai, tu mera dost.
Either it's that or they're just leaving them.
Yeah, and all the guys are like, kissing each other's heads.
Okay, drunk food. From what I hear, it's a big thing, right? Like, what's the... So there are two types of drunk food. When you're drunk and then when you wake up in the morning and you want that grease. Right? Yes. So what's the ultimate cure for the hangover?
Cold pizza.
You want to really know pizza. The ultimate cure?
Alka-Seltzer before you sleep.
Alka-Seltzer before you sleep. 1 liter of water.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Probably a glass of milk. The guy I was talking about is actually me. and next morning when you wake up, a banana milkshake.
Banana milkshake.
If after this you get a hangover, tell me. And I'll tell you I'm sorry. How many people here like shots?
Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
One guy.
Shots, everybody.
I think shots are like that's the final nail in the coffin.
Correct.
Right? Because if you ask anyone, you go out for a night out, next morning you wake up, your head is hurting, and people are like, "Arey bro, tune bahut daru piya ka." "Arey no, dude, I was fine. But that last shot, na." That last shot, no. That fucked me up.
My favorite thing about drunk people is, like, so because I'm not a drinker, I get really bored, okay? Like, there is a limit. I think 3 drinks after everyone's drunk, you're not even in the same wavelength as they are. They're in some other zone. They're like telling you a story. So, you know what happened then? And then a squirrel could pass by and that story's over. Yeah. They don't give a shit about you after that. They'll be like, ah, squirrel must have, bro. Achha, squirrel, achha, adar, tera baal kaisa bana hai. They don't give a shit. They're just moving on, right? So, I'm sitting. My favorite part of this is, it's not really my favorite. You say, achha, listen, let's leave. And they're like, okay, 5 minutes, last drink. Oh my God, that nice. 5 minutes last drink happens at 10:55. 3 baje main chaddi pehen ke so raha hu udhar aur ye log abhi to
you know but that, like, talk about shots again, when that one shot maniac in your group, like, he or she will be the instigator. Hey, you want to have shots? Yeah, let's have shots.
Also known as Karan's
really
uncle.
Excited, right? Everyone's really excited till you do that shot, right? Yeah. Like, yeah, let's do it.
And I don't know what is it with shots. Everyone hates them because you all make the same face exactly. When you take a shot.
It's just the I came face.
Yeah, one
and then you do have salt. So
Yeah.
One thing I hate, like, as a non-drinker, so, like, when I'm out with friends who are drinking, and they're like, they start becoming extra loose.
Or loud.
Loud, yeah. Mm. Yeah! Oh. And I'm out, like, we're in another country, suppose we're, like, traveling outside, and it's just, yeah, 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 and I don't want to be involved, so I'm walking, like, a little away. So they're like, why are you walking away? Because you're drunk, you're not, like, behaving right. No, why won't you let me have fun? Let me enjoy myself.
Dude, you know, drunk people...
Just because you don't drink, you fucking yeah, don't enjoy yourself. You're a truth.
Drunk people become children.
Yeah, drunk, but they've had one beer kyunki usni aukat hai New York mein kharidne ki. To ek beer mein.
But that's the psychosis.
I want to add to this. Okay, like so there's the same thing. Okay, like going abroad and you see people getting drunk. Okay, this story happened in Cambodia. Okay, we're going to Cambodia.
Cambodia.
The one place I've gone, so all my stories come from there. So okay, now in Cambodia they have this main street. Okay, and beer is really cheap there. It's like 50 cents you get a glass of beer. Now, a lot of British tourists come there, okay? They come there to drink. They have a lot of money. The exchange rate is great. And they drink a lot of beer. Now, they've had a lot of beer, and they've come out, and they started doing a dance-off in the middle of the street, okay? So they're doing this dance-off. All the other foreigners know that this is a dance-off. The problem is the Cambodian, like, natives have no idea what's going on, okay?
They're like, should we join them? Should we?
No, so these guys, okay?
May
so
I come in?
No, so so you'll see the Cambodian guys, okay? Now, these guys are like 40-year-olds who fought in the revolution of Cambodia. And they're looking at these Britishers drunk dancing. And they're like, this is what I fought for. My parents have died for this.
I have an abroad story where I saw this in Germany. I was at a bar about 10 o'clock in the evening. So it's not even late by like, you know, European standards. There are two Indian guys, okay? They're drunk already, 10 o'clock, okay? They're drunk. They're in the bar, they're dancing to a Snoop Dogg song. Like this. With each other. They're doing... like next
when is Snoop Dogg's in Sapne?
He didn't. I'm saying they're dancing like Manoj Bajpayee.
Yao, Sapna.
Sapne mein milti.
Milti.
Thank
you for watching this episode of The Big Question with S&G. We are live at the Bangalore Comedy Fest.
Yes.